Welcome students to your English class. Today we are going to do chapter 8 from your grammar book, The Verb. We will be learning what are verbs, types of verbs, transitive verbs, direct object and indirect object, and how to find direct object and indirect object in sentences. Now, what are verbs? We already know verbs are words indicating action or state of being in a sentence. Verbs are also known as doing words, like singing, playing, writing, dancing, running, walking, etc. Now, there are two types of verbs, transitive verbs and intransitive verbs. Today I'll be discussing only transitive verbs. In my next class I'll be discussing intransitive verbs. So let's get started. What are transitive verbs? Verbs that need objects to complete their meaning are called transitive verbs. Examples of transitive verbs: Shyam plays the guitar beautifully. The doctor gave some medicines to the patient. Verbs such as plays and gave need nouns such as guitar, medicines and patient to complete their meaning. Therefore, these are transitive verbs. They have bought a new car. She left the keys on the table. Now, what is direct object? A direct object is a noun or pronoun that directly receives the action of the verb in a sentence. Only a transitive verb can have a direct object. So, children, you have to keep in mind that only a transitive verb can have a direct object. Here, the action transits from the subject through the verb to the direct object. Examples of direct object: Johnny kicked the ball. So, in the above sentence, the action or verb is kicked. The subject, Johnny, performed the action, kicked, and the object, the ball, received the action. The ball is the direct object and the direct object directly receives the action of the verb. Our cat caught a mouse. Cat what? What did our cat catch? A mouse. So you are getting the answer to the question what. So our cat caught a mouse. Caught is the verb, a mouse is the direct object. Disha loves flowers. Loves what? Flowers. So, Disha loves flowers. Flowers will be the direct object. She played the piano. Played is the verb. Played what? Again, you are getting the answer to the question what? She played the piano. The piano will be the direct object. So, whenever you are getting the answer to the question what, it means you are getting the answer to the direct object. Now, what is an indirect object? An indirect object precedes the direct object. It tells us who the verb indirectly affects and who is receiving the direct object. It answers to the question whom or for whom. So, examples of indirect object: Ram passed Shyam the ball. So, in the above sentence, we can see the action moves from the subject Ram through the verb passed to the direct object, the ball, and then the indirect object Shyam. So, what did Ram pass? Ram passed the ball. The ball will be the direct object. Whom did Ram pass the ball? To Shyam. So, Shyam will be the indirect object and past is the verb. My friend sent us a gift. Sent is the verb. What did my friend send? A gift. So you are getting the answer to the question what? So a gift will be the direct object. To whom did she send? To us. So us will be the indirect object. Since you are getting the answer to the question to whom. My parents wrote a letter to the company. What did my parents write? A letter. So a letter will be direct object. To whom did they write a letter? To the company. So the company will be the indirect object and wrote is the verb. Shravani gave me a bag. What did Shravani give? A bag. You are getting the answer to the question what? So a bag will be the direct object. To whom did Shravani give? To me. So me will be the indirect object and gave is the verb. Let us recapitulate what we have learned today. We have learned what are verbs. Verbs are words indicating action or state of being in a sentence. They are also known as doing words. There are two types of verbs, transitive verbs and intransitive verbs. Verbs that need objects to complete their meaning are called transitive verbs. A direct object is a noun or pronoun that directly receives the action of the verb in a sentence. An indirect object precedes the direct object. It tells us who the verb indirectly affects and who is receiving the direct object. So your home assignment for today is what are verbs? Give examples. What are transitive verbs? Give examples. You need to complete the home assignment in your grammar copy. So children, I hope you all have understood what is being taught today. If there is any doubt, you can ask me in the live class. Till then, stay at home, be safe, be healthy. I'll be back in the next class. Thank you, everyone.